Hossaflossa podcast episode
seven. Didn't even know.
Yeah.
Episode 7, y'all. Let's go. We had to do last week's upload a little late because our internet shit.
Yeah.
But this week's is going to be on time.
Oh, T-Fain. Actually, we'll wait a minute. So, T-Fain.
Yep.
Beef jerky is so goddamn expensive.
We haven't talked about that in a while, but beef jerky is getting expensive.
Bro, okay, so I was literally looking in the markdown bin at my work, okay? Yeah. It looked like it was one big piece of beef jerky. It was just like a square, like the size of a fucking vape,
okay? Yeah.
And so, it was $11, and it was marked down. It was $24.99, and it was marked down to
$11.99. Yeah. Me and Jerky getting outrageous. I need a fucking shower, bro.
You look outrageous.
I woke up late. I was even late to work. I had to work at 10:30 this morning.
Yeah, dude, that ain't that bad.
I don't like working.
I'm going to work at 7
on Sunday. I know, but I work evening. I'll go in usually at like 3
or
4.
Yeah, I always work like 4 to 10 or 1:30 to 10.
And I'd work 1:30. Like, that's why I want to work. I'm trying to get more hours. I told him like 1:30, 2:30.
But I mean, bro.
10:30? I do not want to work that early.
But they'd be having me do that. And then.
What time is it right now?
They'd be having me work until 10 and then come in at 7.
I don't even know if I work tomorrow. Watch me work. Where's my phone at? I need to check that after this podcast. Yeah. I swear to God if I work.
Okay. So, T-Fain, this morning, he just texted me at like 8 in the morning or some shit. And he was like, Kevin Ross, we can't do the podcast. I'm so sorry. Today we can't
work,
do the podcast.
But...
And I'm like, what?
I got hope still. I was begging. My parents would let me.
What? And he just didn't say nothing.
I was at work, so I couldn't respond for a while. I was really busy.
He just said, we can't do the podcast tonight. And I'm like,
I was going to text you back later and give you context, but I was busy as fuck at work.
And so, but then he called me back later while I was driving to work, and he was like, yo, we can do the podcast. And I was like, well, fuck, I didn't bring any of my shit from my house that we
needed. It don't matter. You didn't even need to bring it in the first place.
Yeah, we did.
For what? Apple TV?
The Apple TV, the Bubby, the movie.
Oh, yeah, the movie. That was a good... We got to talk about that movie.
We will hear in a few.
Let's talk about it now. We already brought it up.
So, right before this podcast, we watched one of the classic Kangaroo Haas recommended movies.
Mm-hmm. It was a good-ass movie.
I watched this movie 2 years ago. Paprika. Came out in 2006. I think it is the best anime movie to watch just by itself, a movie. You don't have to watch anything else, just the movie.
Yeah.
Just the one movie. And it's only like an hour and a half. But it is so good and so crazy. It's some shit that's like only you could do with animation.
Yeah.
But so, T-Fain, what you think of the movie?
I thought it was good as hell.
Yeah?
I wish I was tripping during that movie. That would make it amazing. That shit would be popping out. That movie was insane, though.
Yeah.
That was a good... I like
what,
it.
I didn't get to get your, you know, initial thoughts because I was waiting for the podcast. What are you thinking initially after watching it?
I loved it. I was like... I was thinking, what if that shit, like, actually... not, like, actually happened, but it's like a dream thing. Like, you could see people's dreams, uh-huh. Share dreams. I was like,
yeah,
damn.
Like the DC Mini?
Yeah. Not like that. Not that shit would happen. Yeah. That shit hopefully would not go down. Fucking take over the world.
So
dreams.
Basically, in that movie, they got something called the DC Mini, which is it's like a dream machine. Okay, so you can put it on somebody and you can go into their dreams. They use it for psychotherapy.
Or you can record them or just like see them after. Yeah.
Yeah. You can play that shit back.
Go replay.
And enter people's dreams. This movie inspired Inception.
Did it?
Yeah. Yeah. But it's crazy. It's a crazy movie. Highly recommend. What's some other shit you were thinking about the movie? You know, some of the shit that happened in the movie Any thoughts about the characters or anything? Any of the shit? Anything that you thought was particularly crazy or mind-blowing?
He was stressing out about that dead body for a while. That cop. Whatever. Yeah, he was stressing detective. Out. Yeah. He was stressing. That's why I was thinking, like, damn, motherfucker.
He's having that dream.
Yeah.
But he was slowly figuring
Dude,
it out.
Dude, those dreams were crazy. I was thinking about that. I was like, who the fuck dreams about this type of shit? It's only in anime someone would dream. I never dreamed about something like that.
I don't know, bro. I guess you just don't dream like that.
I don't remember my dreams like 90%
of
the time.
Dude, I had a dream back in like first grade, dude. I can remember the shit. Me and I think it was Harley Kelsey were there with like some fucking pirate or some shit jumping up and down on pressure plates, dude. I remember that shit.
Yeah.
In the noggin. Because that shit was so crazy. I was like, why the fuck am I here with Harley Kelsey and a pirate jumping down on, up and down on pressure plates? You know what I'm saying? That shit scared the hell out of me. I woke up and I was like, what the fuck?
What the fuck is going on?
I was like, what the fuck? All right. Yeah. But good ass movie. But you know what else I was thinking about? That for some reason the name Trevor is just synonymous with like autistic people.
What? That was so like, random.
Well, I was thinking about it.
Okay? What was that girl's name that was throwing shit that we were talking about earlier? What was that girl's name? Ashley?
I think.
Ashley the shit thrower.
But, so I know two people named Trevor, and they're both autistic.
What's that autistic guy's name? The daily Bible quotes?
Chris. Dude, I love Chris.
I feel like I know a lot of people are named Chris, or it's like Wyatt, or they're
he's got,
something like that.
It's very
Is he the same guy that loves Sonic and shit, too?
Yeah.
Okay. That Sonic inflation.
Which, whenever I think about it, Chris Chan.
Oh my god, Chris Chan, I forgot about that shit. Chris Chan, well, I need an update on Chris Chan. I haven't heard nothing
Chris
about Chris
is
Chan.
Like the cool black version of Chris Chan.
No, he didn't do anything to his mom.
I mean, not really. There's like, you know, there's like three similarities, you know what I'm saying? They're both on the spectrum a little bit. They both really like Sonic. Yeah. They both wear glasses.
Chris Chan
but
is
Trevor.
Down spiral for years. Trevor.
Oh, dude. Oh, my goodness. Dude, the Chris Chan saga
Chris Chan
is unbelievable.
Rabbit hole.
Bro, do you know Wings of Redemption?
It rings a bell. Is that
Wings
a game?
Wings of Redemption? No, dude, that's a guy. He's like as fat as Boogie 2988.
Oh, I think I know what you're talking
Did
about.
Did you see the wrestling match between him and Boogie?
No.
Or a boxing match?
I heard about it. No.
Dude, Keemstar got them in the boxing ring. And they fought. We gotta watch this.
Pull it up. Fuck. I'll do this shit, boy. Keyboard's all pushed up. Oh, we wanna watch this real quick.
We'll watch that later. We'll watch this first.
Something always goes up on my YouTube. Every time I took, like, my old
this
iMac.
This anime. GTA 4.
What the fuck is this? You can hear the desktop audio. I watched it before, it just like mixes together. It's on GTA 4.
I'm about to get a copyright claim already.
We listened to like 6 Kanye songs. A couple podcasts ago.
This is such a great song. Oh. By the time the next podcast comes out or is recorded, Vultures 2, Kanye and Ty Dolla $ign's next duo album should be out.
Oh yeah, we can react to it next podcast.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Okay. Yeah, pull up the full fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, now it's time for the Happy Punch main event of the evening.
What the fuck?
For free, 1 minute
See that sweat dripping off of him.
Shit!
Heavyweight division.
I think
and
that.
And now, making his way to the ring, Boogie 2988!
comes Boogie.
Here comes Boogie.
Team, how you pulled this off?
This is the fight of the century, dude.
Yeah.
This is really a
who has ever gotten this to happen?
Oh my gosh, there he is.
I don't know how I haven't seen any clips of this.
He's wearing the shirt.
Dude, this came out last summer. Bro is built like Mario without the mushroom.
He's got a mustache on. That can't be him. Oh, what an iconic ring walk. You know, Boogie said at the press conference, I won just by being here. You know, and just to make this fight happen, so much went into it.
It's like a meatball with arms and legs.
They have five people spreading those ropes so Boogie can get in.
He's got to kick your ass with them balls.
His boob goes like under his armpits.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent making his way to the ring. Wings of Redemption!
He's coming out. Is he gonna rip his shirt off?
Lit up like a fourth, I'm a happy drunk. Come to pop a big mama, cause your daddy's drunk. I'm gonna pop, pop it up.
He's boring compared to Boogie.
Probably because you have the quality so high.
Guys, we something out of the past.
Man, my eyes are burning. I've been staring at this damn screen.
I have to can't believe this is happening. I'm pinching myself over here.
Turn on the brightness a little more.
Oh my gosh. Well,
ladies and gentlemen, this bout scheduled for 3 1-minute rounds. In the heavyweight division, this bout is also standing 8 count will be in effect. This bout is sanctioned by the Professional Boxing Association. Timekeeper at the bell, Peter McCann. And the third man in the ring in charge of the action, referee Jack Goodwin. And the three judges scoring ringside, Sheamus
Dunn. Have you seen Wings of Redemption?
Yeah, I haven't seen any of his videos
forever. Ladies and gentlemen,
that's what he's talking about for a second. As soon as I saw him, I was like, oh, shit.
Blue corner. He is wearing the green with gold trim. His official weight of 391.6 pounds. And tonight, he's making his crossover debut. Hailing from Fredaville.
Looks like he's about to beat some ass.
The living meme, Boogie, to
I'd be scared of Boogie.
And he's got a lot of fans here. Wow.
He does.
And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner. He is wearing the red and black. His official weight of 404.2 pounds. And tonight, he is also making his crossover boxing debut. Hailing from Conway, South Carolina, Jordan, the legendary gamer known as Wings.
Here we go. We got Paul Bamber in the corner of Wings.
Look at his height advantage on Boogie.
Chase them all look-alike.
Boogie's like a round ball.
Yeah. He's more like a fridge.
3 1-minute rounds.
I like how Boogie took advantage while this was all happening, sitting down in the corner, reserving that gas tank.
Very smart.
The gas tank.
And he's going to need some smarts.
Second round. First round.
Guys, Wings look.
Shit. What the fuck is this shit? What?
This is a real YouTube ad.
It's weird ass YouTube ads nowadays.
knees are ready. Oh my God. Oh my goodness.
Oh, he went straight in. Right off
the bat. Wings is.
Wings connected. He's beating the fuck out of Boogie.
I thought Boogie, Boogie would be in his ass. I was praying on Boogie.
Taking a step back.
He's losing his trousers.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
And ladies and gentlemen, this is and ladies and gentlemen, this is how they arrived on those mark carts. As you can see, pulling up his pants there. They were playing bumper cars.
Who won the race?
I think Boogie did.
Boogie won that one at least.
Pulling them rows up real quick. Right.
You know, we've heard the term saved by the bell, time but for Boogie him? Has been saved by the shorts. The shorts kept falling.
Saved by the shorts.
This could have been a strategy by Boogie, imagine.
He's lost some weight probably training for this fight.
It looks like they're taping him up, taping those shorts.
They're taping him up.
Trying to avoid this London crowd from seeing a full moon.
Yes, I think we're all grateful for that.
Seeing a full moon on a
Boogie
night.
Look at how upset he
looks. Yeah, and it looks like they're taping him up here.
It's like they're really taping him up live in front of the whole world.
This is what I'd like to see. They should not be coming off after that.
No. And you know what?
He's like, they're really taping his ass up.
All crossover boxers, you should be using this to reserve your gas tank and replenish your energy. In future fights.
Dude, look at the front of his arms.
Oh my God, this
I know,
is
I was
awesome.
Thinking, like, what the fuck is that?
The skin is just fucking warped.
Patiently waiting. Oh my God. Dude,
this is a monster.
And they're going for it.
I don't think Boogie's got a single hit on him.
Yeah.
Boogie's
got
to get on it. And there we go.
We made it to the second.
He lasted a round, right? Yep. That's got to be a victory in itself right there.
I mean, they've got to be very proud of themselves. They've, you know, to be in the ring in this on this kind of stage after all they've been through.
How you have to stand up and applaud the fact that we are in round two. I know it's only 60-second rounds, but as you know, in boxing, those rounds are last forever. It's like an eternity.
This is a whole body
right? So the fact that we're in round two is just shocking.
Well, I can tell you that 60 seconds was a lot longer for Boogie than it was for Wings.
That's for damn sure.
He still moves with all that.
Dude, I want a game to be able to do.
No. Fat fighters, bro.
Yeah.
How much more of the pressure he's been taking so game many shots that round. Will he be able to come into this
more
round
Dave.
More
Dave.
More Dave.
We're going to find out.
Round two.
Round two.
Boogie's just got to go for it. He's got to get that Hail Mary punch in.
Boogie's got to face him. There we go. He's just walking into the punches there. At least he's throwing a couple.
He's so red.
I know.
No.
Stop! Stop! Call it. Two, standing eight. There we go. That's the right call there.
Four,
absolutely.
Five, six,
he's out of breath.
Seven, eight.
There it is. That was the right call from the ref. That was the right call from the ref.
Boogie protesting a little bit. But I think it was the right call. And.
Yeah.
Respect to these big men for getting in there. I mean,
absolutely.
That's what this is all about, entertainment. And Keem, you've outdone yourself with this main event.
Well, it's about doing the impossible, and that's what this fight was from the very beginning. To the training, the diet, everything was impossible, and it actually took place. It actually happened. You know, Boogie definitely at a disadvantage physically coming into this match. He's got to be proud of himself for making it through that round. He tanked so much. You know, he could have gone down right away to one of those punches, but he stood there, he took it, and he stood strong. And, you know, he lasted a round, and that's good.
Yeah, Wings had full control from the very beginning, and it looked like Boogie was trying to set up maybe a defense counter, and it just never came.
Doesn't inspire you. I don't know what does. You know, imagine getting ready. And like, every little move, you're carrying around 400 pounds with you.
I hope Boogie's not too upset, because he really made a great effort to get here and do this. And that's the sad part about boxing. There's usually one winner and one loser.
You got a mustache on.
The official time, 33 seconds of round number two. Referee Sheamus Dunn stops the contest, and therefore your winner.
Your wings. He's so proud of himself for winning that match.
Redemption.
Here we go. What'd you think about that?
I've already seen it, Bubby. What did you think about that?
I thought Boogie was going to win at first. I thought he was going to beat some ass. I had confidence in him.
Nah, dude. He got his
ass. If I put a bet on him, I would have fucking lost a shit ton of money.
He got his ass whooped. Oh, you know what we never really talked about?
Huh?
The autistic Trevors.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So there were I had an autistic neighbor named Trevor, yeah, and an autistic coworker.
I'm taking the sweatshirt off. I'm getting hot.
Named Trevor. So yeah. My autistic neighbor, he'd be like, "Brian, what's up?" He'd always want to play basketball.
Yeah.
And you know, I'm not the biggest fan of basketball. But my mom, she'd always make me go outside and play basketball.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But dude, that was in, like, my freshman year.
Freshman year of high school?
Yeah.
She made you play basketball then. I thought it'd be way earlier
than
that.
And he was in his senior year.
Yeah.
But, yeah. But we'd play basketball every once in a while, but I don't know. He was always telling me about, he's like, "Man, these hoes got me frustrated, yo."
Yeah.
He'd be like, "You don't need to get started on that shit." He's like, "It's always a pain in my ass." And he's
it's clogged. I'm not gonna try.
He was always just so pained, yeah, about that shit. Like he's talking about how he was always getting trouble and shit in school.
Yeah.
From whatnot, who bit of whatnot. He's like, "I'm gonna beat somebody up.
Beat some bitch ass."
To beat somebody up, and I was like, all right,
you do you, man.
He's like, "Don't beat nobody up, but I'm about to beat somebody up." Yeah, he's a good kid, though.
He's a good boy.
But then my coworker Trevor, so he was like a friend of one of my dope teachers.
Yeah,
this dope science teacher that I had my freshman year. And so, but he started working there. But, dude, he would not do his job for shit, okay? He'd always, like, walk upstairs into the manager's office and just sit down there for, like, 45 minutes.
Why?
To an hour. Just because he would always say that he was overheating or some shit. He wouldn't bring in more than, like, 3 carts at a time and then stop forever if you didn't tell him to go out and get more. Dude, he couldn't do anything without you telling him to do it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah.
But then, and so he'd always just stop and be talking to people, dude.
Like,
I swear.
People?
Like,
like customers?
Like customers, like a set, like employees, fucking everybody. He wouldn't do any work. Everybody was just so frustrated because he wouldn't do anything.
Does he still work there?
No.
I was about to say.
No, dude, he quit. Because he was talking shit. Because he was talking shit about somebody. He was like, "Jennifer is fat as fuck." And then,
was she though?
And then, she a little big, but still, he was like, "She's a fat bitch."
Yeah.
And everybody loves her. Okay, so that's not, you know, the wisest move. And so, or it was because, like, it was because she, you know, got on to him for being gone for an hour for his lunch.
Yeah. Jennifer's a fat bitch.
And
I
so,
fucking hate her.
Yeah, and so then my homegirl, she told people about it, and so he got, or and so he was in a little bit of trouble with management and stuff. And so then he just quit because everybody was like, "Yo, you did this." Because then, you know, Jennifer got told that he said that.
Well, I'm gonna, Bren just text me. I'm gonna bring something in there real quick. I'll be quick.
You're slow as hell. Say he's gone. And well, T-Fain's gone. I say we go on a little adventure, a little journey. T-Fain, he's been a little zesty lately. I just can't quite put my finger on it, dude. You know what I'm saying? Like, he got them artichokes in his hand, dude. And he's like brandishing them. Alright? Man, I saw his ass pick up a leak. And he just started scrubbing on it. Like, he was getting his fingernails out and rubbing all up on it. What's up?
What's up? I'm gonna start doing this since we're about half hour in.
What? Oh, yeah. Crafting
the blunt.
Okay. Oh. Actually, we should say that for after. Oh, we've been doing this every podcast, we talk about this. So T-Fain, I haven't told you yet.
What?
Or I don't think I did. But Dre has Risk of Rain now.
Finally.
Yeah.
Takes him forever.
He played it while he was at my house. He played it single player.
Yeah.
And he made it further than you and I have ever made it on his first game.
Just a natural.
Evidently, dude. He made it to the final boss and then died at the end of the final boss. Yeah.
At least he didn't make it.
Dude, but he's made it way fucking further than us.
Yeah.
And he was digging that shit.
Did he buy it?
Or no, I got it for him.
Damn. He's spending that money, CR.
Because he was broke, dude. He was like, I got it.
You can tell him to work those fucking shifts at Kroger's. Why ain't he working? Bro.
Dude, he asked the managers if Dre, he could stay till 10
Dre
tonight.
Says he watches some of this. Dre, bro. You need to start fucking working, boy.
Bro. Literally, he said at work, he asked the managers if he could stay till 10 tonight to get more hours, and they were like, yeah, sure. And then he didn't stay till 10.
Why?
Because he's a little puss boy.
Dre, start working.
He's like, I don't want to work this long.
Too bad.
Dude, you're shaking the table. The whole setup's going to fall.
It'll be all right. I'm crafting for the podcast.
Yeah, but why do you need your hands attached to the desk while you're crafting?
I'm tired.
He says, I got to shake the desk. I got to make the whole podcast setup fall over. Okay, I'm T motherfucking Fame. What else can I do?
Gotta get it out.
What I do.
What I do.
What I do.
What I do.
What I do. I'm T motherfucking Fame. Yo, what I do. Oh, bro, you know what this made me think of?
Because
I was thinking of the one scene on Paprika, okay?
Yeah.
That is just like the opening of Prey. Proof life is a simulation. Did we talk about this on the podcast, the proof life is a simulation?
I think we have before. We talked about the whole thing, yeah.
Okay. So, Prey 2017, one of my favorite games ever.
Yeah.
One of, like, the best single-player game experiences I've ever played. Like, what really sold me is, what got me at first was the opening. The opening, I don't want to spoil for people that haven't played the game, but it's fucking crazy. So if you really care a bunch, then maybe skip, like, maybe mute for like 20 seconds, okay? Or 30 seconds. So basically, in the beginning of Prey, so, you know, you got this whole shit going on, this fake-ass job and whatnot, or you think, you know, you on Earth doing some crazy
science
shit
seconds.
With your brother, doing some weird-ass tests, but then some weird shit goes on, and then you wake back up in your room, but everything's fucked, okay? And so there's no way out of the hallway right outside your room. So then eventually, you know, you pull out your little handy doodad wrench, and you break the glass to the outside of your apartment, and that shit shatters, and it, you were never in the apartment ever. It was all just a fake simulation, dude. There was no outside world. It was just a glass screen. And so whenever T-Fain was at my place playing that shit, he was like, proof life is a simulation.
Proof.
But yeah, the second big thing that hooked me on Prey was a couple hours in, maybe 2 hours in or some shit. I went outside the space station, dude.
Yeah.
I went into space, and the space controls are fucking crazy. Dude, like, I felt like I was in space, dude. That shit was so crazy because I was going through, like, maintenance access tunnels and shit outside of the space station, going into places that had been, like, hit with debris, so they were closed off by airlocks.
Yeah.
Shit like that is crazy. But I could go around the whole outside of this whole ass space station. And all of the, parts on the outside of the space station, like all the docks that led you inside, yeah, they were like linked up with where the places were inside the space station. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it's some dope shit. I highly recommend. Oops.
Watch it. I'm not watching. Play it.
Yeah, play it. But yeah, in Paprika, there was a part that was just like that. There was like a broken glass window, yeah, like in reality. And so Paprika went up and touched it, and it freaking broke, or it shattered a little bit more. She walked through, and it was just like Prey.
Yeah.
Proof life is a simulation. Proof. All right, now let me.
You haven't checked that in a minute. Cook.
Okay. Oh, there's somebody at Kroger. Okay.
Yeah.
And so they were coming through. They looked like they had a little touch of the tism, okay, to say the least. And they had a bike helmet on, okay.
Okay.
But you know those fucking memes that have the pictures of like the skeletons with guns and shit, and it's saying, yeah, some like ridiculous shit. Okay, it's like, I like brownies on a Tuesday, and this fucking hardcore skeleton with a biker helmet and a gun and shit, like just fucking pointing it at the camera. He's got all these like chains and shit on. This guy just had, you know, one of those skeletons on his, that like that was his bike, yeah, helmet. His biker helmet was just pictures of those skeletons. And I was like, no way. I wanted a picture of it so bad. Oh my goodness.
Good Lord.
Speaking of my work, dude, they just voted to go on strike, dude. Oh, or they my voted, God. Like they were voting if we should go on strike for the new union contract. And 85% voted to, 85% voted no to the, or to go on strike. I think it was 80% voted no to the proposal. Or I think it was 80% to go on strike and 85%. Wait. 80% no to the proposal, 85% to go on strike. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, I need an energy drink.
I do too. That's what I was thinking. We need to run down the gas station again.
But, dude, we can't now.
Yes, we can.
Pause it. We got the podcast. And how fucking late is it? 4:27.
4:27.
Oh, my Lord.
It's so late.
We'll never be able to go to sleep, though.
I will. You won't.
Now I'm getting fucking tired, dude. Got this come down. We've been up for so goddamn long.
Trying like this is going to keep us up.
Literally, we just kept getting pushed from doing the podcast over and over again.
Brian got up and we were about to.
Yeah, we were busy setting shit up forever and doing shit. T-Fain kept installing shit. And then we watched the movie. And then we came in here and we're getting everything finally finished and set up. And Brenna woke up and came in. And so we went out there with her for a little bit. But, yeah, and now we finally are doing the podcast.
Maybe this should stay on there. Kind of broke a little bit.
Yeah.
Kind of cracked.
So we might be going on strike. So that's a little crazy. Oh, dude. Bryce was at your house, T-Fain.
He kept telling me to whip it out. And Bren was saying that.
He was. He was doing that.
I don't know if he was joking or being serious. What do you think?
I don't know. I think it's really up to interpretation.
I hope he wasn't being serious. He's got a fucking Kraken on both sides. It's pissing me off. Might not be able to smoke the most.
Gun Geezy. Dude, I am yawning.
I'm about to light this. You good?
Yeah.
I'll be back. Do you want to pause it while I light this? Or do you want to...
No, I'll just take the podcast on a little journey. You know what I'm saying?
I'll take a drink before I go light this. I'm thirsty.
Just take the podcast on a little journey.
BRB.
See, I'm the ultimate
Talk about
host.
The background real quick.
I'm the ultimate host.
The Young Havoc.
Oh, yes, sir. All right. So this picture, background, it's a little stretch res picture of Young Havoc, the classic. All right, except he looks really goofy in this picture. Okay. Actually, we'll pull up the full image. Right here, we got the full image, Young Havoc looking very goofy. Why so serious, Young Havoc? Oh my goodness. Boy, we got a story about Young Havoc. Boy, have we got a story about Young Havoc. So the classic word on the street, I can, you know, who knows if this is true or a rumor? Who knows? But classic word on the street says that he stabbed his sister over a Beyblade. In Minecraft. So... yeah, that's the classic. I don't have my watch. So we can't keep track of how long this motherfucker's taking. I swear, T-Fain's always taking so long. So long. Oh my goodness. Yeah, that reminded me of a story, okay? Oh, there is... okay, at work. So we know Shane, okay?
Yeah.
So there was... so we were at work, and so... Shane was doing some goofy-ass shit, so I picked his ass up. I just...
you picked him up. And
he was standing on some boxes or some shit, and so I just picked his ass up and moved him out of the way. And so then my coworker Abby, she was like, "You guys are gay."
Why'd you pull up the picture of Young Havoc? What the fuck?
And so he was like, "You're gay." And
it's Young Havoc. Did you screen share that?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I was showing him the full image. But, oh. Yeah, so she said that we were gay as hell. And he was like, "You're gay." And so this black guy was walking by, okay? And then later, whenever he was walking out,
yeah,
he said, "You're
this.
Gay to somebody." Or he said something like the word gay.
Yeah.
And then the black guy turned around and he was like, "I've heard you say this 2 times." And he just gave them this whole rant. He's like, you finna get in trouble, bro. He's like, keep gay people out of your mouth.
That a little bit hard. It was a little weird.
He said, keep gay people out of your mouth. He said, I'm not gay, my boy. But that's finna get you in trouble. He's like, all people, bro.
Yeah.
And Shane, he's like, all people. All people.
All people.
All people. And so afterwards, he was like, I should have just said that I was gay.
You should have. Like, man, I'm gay. I have a boyfriend. I'll call him right now. He'll beat your ass.
He said he was going to get in trouble. I was like, I mean, that's totally true. He totally could get in trouble, in a little bit of trouble for that.
Yeah. There. That's a great bit. Shit.
The classic scrape technique.
Classic scrape.
Oh. You wanna talk about... Oh. Dre got his new freaking mic, finally.
Sing pop. Oh, yeah.
Oh, there we go. We heard that. We heard that pop.
Oh, I taste it now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Let me see that.
Hold up.
I gotta taste it.
It doesn't even taste like weed now. Taste it?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yo, that is pink lemonade.
Yep.
That I taste. That,
that reminds me of old vape I had, like freshman year. Tastes just like I had a pink lemonade vape. It was disposable. Tastes just like that. Shit, actually. Damn. Hopefully it doesn't leak right there.
That's good.
Yeah.
It didn't do that well on the first one.
I don't think I really popped it. The first time.
You were just lying?
I don't know. I kind of heard a pop, but I don't know. That time we really heard a pop, though.
Yeah. Loud. They probably heard that shit on the podcast.
Yeah.
It was so loud. Yeah. Dre finally got his new fucking mic.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness, dude. He's been running on that fucking Five Below mic. $5 Below mic.
For
ages, forever, dude.
That's all the three of us have been playing. He's had that damn Five Below mic.
The whole time that I've played with him, too. He's had that damn Five Below mic. He's had so many issues. Okay. And finally, he was like, my mic has a mute button. He's like, yo, this is crazy.
Yeah,
and I'm like, dude, every single fucking mic has a mute button.
Mine has a mute and volume, bro.
Literally. Either it's got a button or you can flip the mic up. The one
down there has a pause button. Like, bro. He's finally getting them new updates.
Yeah, bro. Bro has been on Leopard forever. Bro has been running Windows 98 since 98. Okay.
What the paper doing that shit? The fuck? Getting us up.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Say that's what we needed.
Well, I need it. I feel more awake now.
Yeah. For
this
real.
Feels good.
For real. Yeah, that's solid. That's what 25 bucks at Joe's gets you.
Oh, yes. Shit. I just got it right on my fucking pants.
You fucking idiot.
Pink lemonade.
Dre got his new mic.
Leaf rolls.
But
finally, shit.
What about the most infamous mic?
Harley Kelsey Tornado.
The
mic.
Harley mic. Have we talked about the Harley Tornado mic?
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck. We're talking about it again. Okay. Harley Kelsey. Notorious Harley Kelsey. for raging at video games, okay?
With his horrible-ass mic.
But he didn't always have a horrible mic. But there was a period of time, and that was a lot of the time that me, or that T-Fain played with him, me and him, okay?
Bryce Way played with us a little bit, too. Remember that? Can we please get him on here on a podcast? I'll ask him if he wants to get on.
Bryce Way?
Yeah.
Or Harley Kelsey?
Both. We can have them both on separate times. Or two at the same time.
The reunion.
Both of them at the same time if we get a fourth mic. We can just bring in the original mic we used on the first podcast to get four people. Let's figure out that echo that we could.
No, we're going to get another one of these mics.
We're going to get another one of these. But get one of these. I like this. We're going to get another rainbow. You and me can have the rainbows. And then the guest can have the red. Who's really guesting?
Yeah, man. So Harley, for this period of time, okay? So, his mic was just so horrible, dude. It would just turn into a real tornado.
We need a lighter in here.
Dude, remember?
His ass mic.
But it would just start sounding like a fucking tornado, dude. The static and shit was crazy. But it didn't even sound like static, you know? Like, it sounded like a tornado. Sounded like crazy wind going through his mic. Oh my goodness, dude. My nose is clogging up right after we started this podcast. I've been fine all day. All freaking day. T-Fain, my nose is clogging up for this podcast. I've been fine all goddamn day.
Fuck you. My eyes were killing me at the beginning and before this podcast.
Oh, I know. I know.
Fix that shit.
Oh, T-Fain. So, riddle me this, T-Fain. What are some of your favorite albums?
We've talked about this. I told you I can't choose. We've already had a whole discussion about this on different podcasts. Yeah.
I don't know if I believe you.
We have. I remember it.
You don't have any albums that you like.
I do. I told you I can't choose between them.
Well, you don't have to say any ranking.
I just can't. What are some really good albums? I just can't bring up stuff on the spot like this. We talked about this, bro. I just can't.
You can't think of any albums that you like.
I can't think of anything right now, bro.
You're lying.
I'm not lying. I can't.
You're fronting for the Hossaflossa audience.
I could show my playlist on the podcast if you want, but I can't.
You can't think of a single album that you like. I don't believe this man.
Actually, I don't want my email to show. I think it shows at first. Here's a podcast. Here's a... Scroll down. Scroll around through that and have a little view.
Bam, bam. Free Trap. Arizona Baby. Dude, I've never heard of, almost any of these people. Oh, wait. Oh, my goodness. I'm reading the fucking album. Jesus Christ.
Artist is right here.
Okay, Lil Durk. Schoolboy Q. Kodak Black. King Von. Where's Chief Keef?
I don't know. I haven't really listened to that much Chief Keef anymore.
Gucci Mane. Where's Chief Keef?
I think he's more at the end of the podcast. There's I know there's one in here.
Waka Flocka Flame.
I keep saying podcast playlist.
It's at the end of the podcast. Yeah, we can't do it right now. It's locked to the end of the podcast. It's locked to it's the locked. End of the podcast. Wizard Money Gang says so. Rick Ross at the end of the podcast. I didn't see any Chief Keef.
I don't know how movie I am.
Pooh Shiesty. Why are these all just emojis?
I don't know. I don't know what to name my playlist, so I just put it something. There's some Chief Keef. Instagram.
Fain. Okay, yeah, there's Chief Keef.
Close this shit. I don't want to listen to this right now.
Is this Apple Music?
Yeah.
Damn, I thought I wasn't finna come on this bed.
Yeah.
We are listening to this. For some reason, T-Fain has not heard this.
Take a shiny drink.
Okay. T-Fain has not heard Chicago.
Oh, yeah, you're talking about this. Can you throw in that trash over there?
Met her on the way to Chicago, where she was all alone.
2014, his ass has been dead.
So his eyes asked her for a name.
This came out after he died.
She smiled and looked at me.
That AI Michael Jackson
was there. I was surprised to see that a woman like that was real into me.
She says you didn't have no man. Played the game the very best she had. She told me she was all alone.
Never would have thought she was living like that. Her words seemed so sincere. When I held her near, she would tell me how she feels. It felt so real to me. This girl she had to be. An angel sent from heaven just for me.
She said you didn't have no man.
Fuck off. You were working the game.
So what we got the screen share up, I've got a video to show T-Fain.
Okay? It's that video that you have.
So just think of this video with just the caption, he did all that for a dollar.
He did all that for a dollar. Or do anything for that dollar. I've seen the full part. You've not looked comfortable. He's scared. Yeah.
He did all that for a dollar.
Oh my god. What? What are you doing? This gay ass motherfucker.
How many topics do we have left? Did we already talk to them all?
No.
Hold up, where's... I'm grabbing.
Actually, I got something to send you on Discord. Yeah, bro. Oh, give me a couple of them. Oh my god, dude. This is the worst bag. Man, whoever invented these bitches is a genius. Oh, there's one topic on here. It says retard in the Elantra. And I can't remember what it even means.
Think hard.
I can't. I didn't remember what guy with skull helmet meant either. But damn, man.
What's Chris Rant video?
Well, I just sent that to you on Discord. Just watch
it. Switched, up. Shit, I didn't mean to write it down.
So my boy from work, Trenton... He sent us this video from work. Does it have audio?
Okay, now go on about your rant.
Dom Toretto is a goat. He literally hit a crane with his car and didn't even crash damage here. That is so rare in these days. You don't have cars built like that. You have cars.
Okay, now go on about your rant.
Dom Toretto is a goat. He literally hit a crane with his car and didn't even crash damage. That is so rare in these days. You don't have cars built like that. You have cars that are built for a crush impact. And so Dom Toretto car makes him safer. Plus, it basically saved Rome. That's crazy.
Dominic Toretto, bro.
It's crazy.
That's crazy.
Mmm, I feel good.
I know. Another classic banger from Chris.
Another classic. It's 4:54 in the morning. Mm-hmm. What else did you get when we're at 7-Eleven other than the Pringles and that?
Hot fries.
Hand me some of them Pringles.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
I'm munching on the podcast tonight. It's so late. Shit. This is the latest we've ever done a podcast. It's 4:54 in the morning.
And we're just now an hour in.
We're just now an hour in?
Yep.
Hour and 1 minute.
Do we have FL on this? God damn it, T-Fain.
I can get it real quick.
You can install that shit.
Let's just do it while we're talking.
Yeah. And then we can do that shit later.
Yep.
Morgan Mumphrey, we should ping him.
Actually, yeah, because it's like it's, 9 yeah. or 10 in the morning there.
Yeah. Now he won't be as pissed off.
Oh, that's why I call him.
The Quadcast S is yours. So I'd be talking to Morgan Mumphrey. I'm on the bus. Bro, what are you talking about? He says, I'm on the bus. Thomas, I'm on the bus.
Can't call baby girl.
Thomas, I'm on the bus. Can't call baby girl. No, no, lol. He just said, no, lol. Morgan, you piece of shit. Yeah, yes,
give me
sir.
Another one of those nerds again. Fuck.
These nerds, dude.
Get a couple of them things.
Other than Bubby Tangs. I need some of them Bubby Tangs.
No, no.
Dude, there's like none left.
Oh.
There's like five left.
Things are so good. Keep me up.
That's why I got two bags.
I'm gonna grab me a Coke
real quick. I've left so many times this podcast.
A Coke?
Yeah.
Give me a Coke. Yeah. We just chilling. You, me, Young Havoc. You know what I'm saying? Brother, I'm on the run. Dude, you know what we got to work on tonight?
What?
After the podcast? Remaking Booba 2.
Mm-hmm.
Send me some of them files.
I will. Have we went through all the topics already?
No.
Oh.
Oh, so T-Fain.
Hmm.
I think we should ping Morgan.
No.
He's on
he's
the bus.
He's already up. No.
He's on the bus.
Nah, bro. I can't remember. Okay. I think, yeah.
But yeah. So T-Fain.
Yeah.
You know, I'm assembling my World Eaters army. Mm-hmm. For Warhammer 40K. Alright. So, for y'all who don't know, the World Eaters in Warhammer 40K are Chaos Space Marines. That means that they're basically evil Space Marines. He got this big old armor on, but it's got a bunch of spikes on it. Okay, they're evil. They got teeth and spikes and claws. And so they worship one of the chaos gods, dude. And so this one is Khorne, the god of blood. And so he's basically the god of fucking killing people and shit.
Yeah.
And so they got the world leaders. And the world leaders, they all got these fucking metal, like... They're called the butcher's nails, okay? Yeah. But they're these fucking, like, metal electric, like, wires that go into the back of their head.
Yeah.
And so it makes them fucking angry all the time and want to kill people. Okay? Because their Primarch, their leader guy...
Yeah.
That they were all genetically based from, Angron. So he, like... For some reason, their mommy, okay, dispersed them across the universe. For some reason. Or not the universe, the galaxy. For some reason. Because she was like, the Emperor is going to do bad things with these kids.
The Emperor.
And so, but Angron, the planet that he went on, they put these fucking butcher's nail spike wires into his head so that he'd fight in the Colosseum and want to kill people. And it just fucked him up, dude.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But yeah. So then he turned against the Emperor. Fuck. Smacking this shit. So he went against the Emperor. And he's evil.
He's evil as fuck.
You know, but I got the combat patrol box, and so I finally started a 40k army, so I can paint them bitches up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I had my combat patrol box, which had, you know, my Khorne berserkers, my space marine guys, some chaos cultist jackals, and some freaking... It's like a guy riding a machine bull. If it was evil. Okay? It was evil.
If.
And so, So I also had a pack of some demons. Okay? But so, then, the other day, I went to my local game store. And I got some 8-bound, and so they're like some crazy space marine guys.
Yeah.
That, you know, they got like some demon. They got 8 demons inside of them, possessing them. So they're pretty powerful in the game.
Yeah.
I got their Primarch Angron, and he's a crazy looking demon guy. I'm gonna pull up a picture.
Open image another tab. Yeah.
Okay.
There we go.
Alright. Yeah, this is fucking Angron, dude. He's crazy. But yeah, so in the game, so he's crazy in the game. But if he dies, dude, if you roll a 666, 3 sixes, then he comes back to life.
Hold up.
Which is crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I got Angron, and then I got the Khorne Lord of Skulls.
It's right there.
This fucking thing. And so he's big as fuck compared to all the other miniatures.
Okay? Yeah.
He's like the crazy ass demon.
$185.
Dude, I got that shit for fucking cheap, dude. Literally on like. Oh. Shit. Jesus. Here, now we can have it in the middle of the screen so that it's not obscured. But yeah. Dude, this shit was like $900 on eBay. I was like, what the fuck?
Fucking eye. Fuck.
Yeah. I got it for way fucking less than that.
Yeah.
The game store in there. And they gave me the Thursday discount. It wasn't even Thursday. Thursday discount. But I got 10% off that shit. Let's go. But yeah. So. But that guy. I was like, damn, bro. I can get this motherfucker whenever he's $900 on eBay.
Yeah.
That's easy.
My eyes are fucking starting to itch. Because, you know.
Then if I want to fucking sell it, then I can just put it on eBay for $900. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Make like crazy.
Hella profit.
Yeah, crazy profit.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and he's also good in game.
Fuck.
You are tweaking.
My eye.
Tweaking off the rocks, T-Fain.
I need a piss.
You've been on those pills, those perkies?
End it in about Percocet. 10 more minutes where we usually end it. Because I'm starting to get tired. I just want to do stuff after the podcast.
Yes,
I'm not going to sleep right after.
Okay.
I just want to get stuff done before I do get to sleep, finally.
Yeah. Let me look at... Let me look at what we got on here.
Let me start this, because... Oh! We can talk about all the podcasts. You can get on FL at the end of the podcast.
Yeah. Let me send this picture to you,
T. No, I need to get it back. Alright, damn.
If it'll freaking send. Okay. It did send. Dude. Today at work. So my coworker, okay, she's also my supervisor.
Yeah.
Okay. So, this guy got into two verbal altercations with her in the freaking store. Okay, in the same day. Two different occurrences.
Yeah.
So, basically, he was trying to walk off with his toilet paper without paying. And then he was getting in my coworker's face. And shit, after she was like, yo, you didn't pay for that.
I want to talk
So she was like, yo, get, like, you're leaving, bro.
Yeah.
And so then he just started fucking yelling. He was pissed. So then he left. But then he came back. Me and Dre, we were on break in the car. We just came back from McDonald's.
Yep.
Okay. So we got us some McDonald's, and then we just heard people yelling outside. And so Dre opened the door, and so it was my coworker and this guy. They were both right outside the front doors, okay?
Yep.
And so, like, it looked like he was about to fucking fight her, but he came back in and tried to steal his toilet paper back again. Okay? So he was pissed. He was fucking screaming.
Tweaking.
Yeah. He was like, you cannot come back in this store, bro. And so then Dre came over there. He was fucking yelling. Yeah. Two verbal altercations. All that for a fucking pack of toilet paper. But, oh, T-Fain, you got your trap house story.
Oh, yeah, we went past the trap house in my old neighborhood. Jay and Caden forever ago, and there's some pregnant lady outside. There was like a big ass fight, and he's like kicked her stomach. I was like, damn. There's so many people around and shit, just watching. Like, dude, so I'm gonna do something. We're just driving past
the trap house. Yeah. Was that the trap house story?
Uh huh. It's Dang. Not that long. That's what I was saying.
That's real. Oh, I sent you something on Discord to pull up.
What is this?
In a little bit.
Shit.
T-Fain can't even zoom in. Okay. So my boys at school, Levi and Taylor, okay, so we had to make some fucking, we're doing this budgeting project, okay, so we had to plan a party for the class with only $30. This is my financial algebra. Okay. And so then we had to make like a thing, you know, to show our party or whatever the fuck.
My fucking eye, bro.
And so my boys Levi and Taylor, they made this water party.
Water
snacks,
party.
Snacks, goldfish, drinks, water, games, ring toss, horseshoe.
Horseshoe. I can't even read the prizes.
Yeah, I don't know.
Water party.
I think it says something. Then it says gum.
Yeah.
And then it says I can't even tell. But dude, they got those goldfish, dude. And then the print out of the water and the freaking grass.
Yeah.
I think they said for decorations it would be grass. Fake grass. I was like, dude, that is so the water party, dude. That's so based. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're gonna have them both on as guests.
Yeah. Eventually we'll have a bunch of people on. Coming soon.
Yes, sir.
We're gonna start having clips soon.
Oh, dude, we should have already had clips.
You wanna work on some after the podcast?
I don't know.
It's up to you.
Maybe.
Or some other time.
We'll see. We'll try and work on some this week. Yeah. So I got one final extended story, okay?
Yeah.
So, you remember, oh, you weren't even there.
What?
Were you there for Ben's birthday party?
When?
I don't know.
Not
it was
with
at
you.
His house with
I was
Aiden
at one.
And shit.
Yeah. Were you there?
Yeah. I was at one of them. It was like me, Nigel, Tommy Jones.
Yeah, those people were there at one with me, but you weren't there.
Braden the Guzman. Ago. There was a.
Yeah, him too, bro. What?
Derek.
Derek's everywhere.
Not anymore, dude. His girlfriend doesn't let him go anywhere. Neither does his parents now.
Why is his parents not? You get in trouble?
Because, like, he got in trouble for, like, drinking once.
Of course.
And then, like, they didn't like that he was smoking weed with his buddies.
Yeah.
Whatever. And they were like, you can't go anywhere because
you
we don't
leave.
Because we don't trust any of these kids.
Yeah.
But his girlfriend also doesn't want him to go places. So he just doesn't hang out with anybody anymore.
Yeah.
It's been like a full year that he just hasn't hung out with anybody. It's like, okay. It is what it is. But, so Ben's birthday, it's a classic, okay? And so we got so fucking faded. Dude, there's the unreleased Aiden video. Dude, we got so much footage of it, and he was making the video.
Yeah.
But then he scrapped it, because like 2 weeks after the shit came out, whenever he was about to release the video, like it was finished and it was sick. Well, the fake allegations
of Ben,
they, and so he was like, I can't make this video,
who the fuck
he's
cares
evil.
anymore.
even though it's some bullshit, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah. So, but the party was insane. It was a classic. We got so fucking high.
Yeah.
And so there's some classic moments then, okay. Like the hot dog dart.
The hot dog dart?
The hot dog dart.
What the fuck is that?
I'll tell you about the hot dog dart. So Nigel, or so there's a dart board in the basement at Ben's house, okay, with darts. And so we had hot dogs down there. And so Nigel came up with the genius idea to squeeze a hot dog onto the dart.
Bruh. Okay. Of course, Nigel would come up with the brilliant idea.
And to throw it at the dartboard with the hot dog on it. The hot dog dart.
For this podcast.
I think that we got it to stick one time. Okay. Yep. It just kept bouncing off. But I think we got it to stick one time. But that meetup, it's a classic. Okay. So we started off, we were bowling. Okay. We're at the bowling alley. And then we met up in the, bathroom and got a crazy group photo. But, so we were bowling, chilling, and we went back to Ben's house. Oh, Dalton was there for the, I know at least the bowling, I think. And I recorded, like a Pimp My Ride video.
Pimp My Ride.
Yeah. But that did get released. That was the only footage that got released from that whole thing. But I don't think it's up anymore. I don't know if there's any way to find it.
I think Aiden still has them up. He's got to find his new YouTube name.
I don't know. I can see.
I don't know.
But so we started out bowling, and then we went over to Ben's house. And we got faded as fuck, and we were watching, like, we were listening to and watching some crazy shit on the TV.
Yeah.
And, like, jamming, playing some shit. And we were just getting up to all kinds of hijinks. We got high as fuck, dude. Derek took, like, the fucking double blinkers off my shit.
Yeah.
And so he just fucking started coughing till he almost threw up. Okay. And then he was so fucking faded, okay. He was like, I'm not gonna smoke. I need to save my lungs for swimming. It's like, bro.
You're gonna be fine.
Hitting a cart one time is not gonna ruin your lungs irreparably for swimming.
You can't go swim no more.
I can't do swimming anymore.
Vaping will do that. Carts will ever after a long time.
But, so then, he finally hit it. Okay.
Yep.
And so he got so faded, dude.
The first heroin Derek high?
Yeah. Okay. And so he got so faded. Okay. I got crazy pictures of him and Ben and shit, dude. And I was tweaking too. But yeah, Derek, he had the dinosaur bike helmet on with the spine mohawk that lit up orange. Okay? He had his glasses on and shit. He was just fucking faded. He was like, with that fucking, like, helmet on. Actually, I got a picture. I'm gonna pull that shit up. What was I looking up on YouTube?
Just skip it. I wanna end the podcast soon, bro. We ain't watching no more videos.
Well, I was seeing if the,
He has some weird ass name now, and he made a new channel.
Yeah, but I was sub to him still.
You sub to his new channel?
I mean, he wouldn't have re-uploaded the videos.
Yeah, but I don't know what his old one. He still changed.
Let me find the picture of Derek though. But yeah, so we were faded as fuck. But Derek was so tweaking that, like, Nigel pulled up with a pizza cutter on him. Okay. Yeah. And he started, like, slicing on him, and he just freaked out. Like, he thought that he was being cut to pieces.
I'm gonna skip it if you can't find it.
No, dude, it'll be... What are you talking about, dude?
I cannot wait to take my
What time is this? Oh, this is way after.
What the fuck?
Shit, they're not in my favorites.
Here. He's not digging for that, bro.
Which here, that's my pictures. That's my that's my image for Derek on just messages. For him.
Derek Fartson, show him to the camera. I'm not going to show the contact on there. There okay. He is. He had us in the.
And then we're sending that to the Discord.
Put your Tinder on your phone.
That's not Tinder.
He has Grindr on his phone. I just saw it. It's I swear to God.
Grindr.
He's fucking. He's getting fucked okay. by boys. Oh yeah, I was fucking scrolling past Grindr on the App Store. Me and Bren were looking at it. I'm just like looking at it. It says 17 plus.
Oh yeah, you told me that.
Like what the fuck?
Yeah. So that. There's
fucking Derek Farson.
Oh, you gotta zoom in. That is Derek with the
old Derek Farson.
Oh my goodness. Look at how faded he is. And so he was just slumped out like that on the couch. Yeah. And so then he got up, okay? And he fell down in the kitchen. What, like, meanwhile, all this shit's going down, and Ben and Tommy are just, like, crafting a gravity bong out of a fucking milk jug in the kitchen, okay? They've been crafting for, like, 25, 30 minutes.
You want to craft a gravity bong thing. After this?
I don't know. I don't know if I got the time and patience for that shit. Because we could be working on the Booba 2, dude. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know if we're going to do that tonight. I got such
Booba 2 Revival.
Mac OS.
You got to at least send me those files,
I'll send
dude.
Them to you tomorrow at least, but I don't know about tonight.
No, dude, because I got to wake up and leave at like 9.
I can work on them things after work. It's five. It's almost 5:30, bro.
Yeah, bro. But, yeah, so his ass, he got up and he fell over.
Yeah.
Okay, and so he's on the ground. So I went over to pick him up, okay? Because he had his hand up. And I was like, I'm going to fuck with this dude.
I'm going to fuck with this dude. You said you don't fuck with this dude?
I said, I'm going to fuck with him.
Oh.
Okay? And so I was like, three. Or I was like, three. Two. One. Go, 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 go. And I was like, grabbing him and pulling him up. But, and then I'd get up like halfway and then let go. Okay? And I've done this on two occasions. Because there was Ben's birthday meetup, but right before was the Kangaroo Hoss birthday meetup.
Yeah.
Which is the first time that we did that. And that was the first heroin Derek.
First heroin Derek.
Yeah, the first heroin Derek. Or actually, oh, never mind. That was the, yeah. But he had all the shit on. And so he just, I kept doing that same exact thing to him. He was on the ground and I kept faking him out.
Yeah.
And letting go of him like he was too heavy and restarting. And that went on for like 10 minutes. 5 or 10 minutes. I think it was only like 5 minutes, but still. And so he never got a hint. So then I just walked away because it was boring. I got bored.
Fucking eyes.
Yeah. Oh, dude. And then Ben's dad came down and started smoking
Ben's
with
dad
us.
Looks so old, bro. Like, I don't know, he's not that old, but
yeah,
like,
he was like Kangaroo Hoss. He was calling me Kangaroo Hoss, and I was losing my shit, dude.
I remember Ben's dad was cool as hell.
I was like, dude, and Ben blamed all the shit on you. Smearing the dog shit. He was like, who fucked up all this shit? Why does it smell like dog shit? It was T-Pain. It was all T-Pain.
And so he told his dad that.
Oh, my Lord.
Do you have any...
Oh, my Lord, Lord, Lordy, Lord. But, yeah, he came down. He kept calling me Kangaroo Hoss, and I was losing my mind. I was like, no way, this is real life. Okay? And what's even crazier is that he was a teacher at my school, bro.
I know, he worked at Page.
Yeah.
His mom was a counselor at South, but then she had that accident.
The accident?
She, like, fell down the stairs or something, I think.
Oh, shit.
You got any last remarks before we get off here? Last my remarks. Eyes are killing me. I can't wait
anymore.
What about
anymore. FL?
Mm-mm.
No.
Not tonight, no.
Damn.
I can't wait anymore. My eyes are killing me.
All right. Well.
I'm waiting for your story.
Hossaflossa. Watch Hossaflossa Paprika.
Episode 7.
And hopefully Vultures medicine. 2 comes out in time for the next podcast.
We'll let
see y'all next week.
We're doing the next one way earlier. I'm not staying up this late again.
See y'all next week.
See y'all next week.
See y'all next week.